Hello, everybody. My name is Brian Harklerode. I'm a field service engineer out of the Houston office, and today I'm going to be showing you all our mud motor performance dashboard and our Petrolux upstream drilling demo. So one of the leading causes of downtime on a drilling rig are mud motor failures. So what we've done here with this dashboard is come up with an easy way for drilling engineers to be able to assess the performance of their mud motors. So historically, drilling engineers have a mud motor handbook where they would actually have to flip to the page for the particular mud motor model that they're using and then plot the differential pressure and torque to understand, where they are within the operating limits of that particular mud motor. So what we've done here on the right is we're actually using the XY scatter plot to plot the differential pressure and torque in real time on that mud motor performance curve so they can immediately understand how optimally they're operating that mud motor. So over here on the left, we're tracking some of the key parameters for mud motors, such as motor output RPMs, motor output torque, string RPMs, and bit RPMs. And then down over here on the bottom right, we're tracking all of our mud motor stall events. So what actually causes mud motors to fail is when you actually start stalling out the mud motor. So it'll actually chunk out the mud motor and you'll have to pull it out of the hole and change it out. So we're tracking all of those events so that we can acknowledge them and understand, hey, we just stalled out the mud motor. We need to call out there to the drilling rig and make sure that they're following proper stall procedure and taking those lessons learned and making sure that we're not operating using the same parameters that caused us to stall the motor in the first place. And so down below here, in the bottom left, we have our differential pressure. So that's one of the key parameters for mud motors. We don't want our differential pressure to exceed a certain level, or else that's going to cause a mud motor stall. So we have our gauges here that shows us color-coded, how we are operating that particular mud motor. And then here we are using the trend to show our motor output RPMs and our torque on bit. So we want to be able to see how those relate to each other.